things. And I wasn't thinking. I put dots in and then.
Oh gosh, thank you, Tom, so much. I must say that this whole film was Marianna's idea. She called me up and she said, "I have an idea to make a film." And my first reaction was like, "Oh, I'm too tired to make another film," because it was right after I finished Crash Reel. And then I couldn't say no to her, as you'll see why when you see the movie. And to start with, we just made it our little film. But the goal was to raise awareness about Huntington's disease.
And I told her what I was going to do, that I was getting tested. And, you know, before that, she had said she wasn't going to be able to do anything. And then she was like, "Okay, well, let's meet and talk about it." And then from there, it just escalated into us deciding to change the world together. And she's so amazing. I'm honestly so blessed to have met her and to have known her this whole time. She's amazing.
Lucy, how do you know Maria?
We have a mutual friend, and we both had films at Sundance. And then we emailed, and we were very excited to meet each other. And then we got to Sundance, and I didn't even check my email for a week.
Me
and
neither.
We never met. And then I got this phone call out of the blue right after a Crash Reel premiere. So it was like 18 months ago. Yeah. And Marianna said, "I've got a feeling we should make a movie." And I was like, "Oh, I'm so tired. I'm so sorry. I can't. But tell me about what's going on, and I'll help you." And then she started telling me about it, and I just thought, oh my goodness. First of all, how do you say no to this woman? I couldn't do that, certainly. And secondly, I thought, honestly, you know, thinking with my cap on, well, there's a few things. I thought Marianna really has been a spokesperson for HDSA, Huntington's Disease Society of America. And I realized, because she was such an amazing person on screen, and this Huntington's disease is what they call an orphan disease. It lacks kind of a famous person. And because it also runs in families, so people who don't have it in their families aren't at risk of it. So people tend to hear about it a little bit less, because it's either in your family or it's not. And so is a real need for awareness. In fact, even, for example, like a couple of months ago, there was a guy who was beaten up by the cops because they thought he was resisting arrest because he had the uncontrollable movements. And it's a horrible video, and you can look at it online. It's just really heartbreaking story that so many people just don't know about this disease and get very confused by it and really results in terrible pain. And I've actually got a flyer for everybody about HD that you all, just because you know about it now, if you tell one person about it, then that will also help. And also it needs funds, so we've raised some money, and that's really exciting because they're actually, the research is actually really exciting right now. We really, there's some really, really, really good research happening, which is great because so far there's no cure, but we're on the brink of some really amazing breakthroughs, which is amazing. And I realized that Marianna being so good on the screen, we had a real opportunity to raise awareness like never before. And secondly, I must say, I'd had this amazing experience with Crash Reel, with Kevin, that sometimes when you're going through something really, really, really hard, having a camera around can lend a sense of purpose. And I wanted Marianna to have that. I wanted Marianna to know that what she was doing with her courage, she had the courage, if she had the courage to film it, I was gonna damn well work with her to make an amazing movie. So we wanted to make this movie to really validate Marianna's courage in opening this experience to us.
So Marianna, it's one thing to have the courage to say, "Hey, come film this." Then it's a second step to actually have this film out in the world. Can you talk about what that's been like?
So true. One of the things that did actually help me was watching the Crash Reel, because I feel like there is a theme through Lucy's work that is about bravery in times of pain and sharing your pain as opposed to trying to deal with everything by yourself. I think the film is in a lot of ways about friendship and about family and being able to do the difficult things together as opposed to by yourself. And so I think that part of what was helpful about doing the film with Lucy was that I got to like process stuff with my friends in this environment that was really essentially private, you know, which was odd because we were making a film. But what was great about working with Lucy was that she was able to say, like, you know, at every point, like, if I was uncomfortable with something, we just didn't do it. So she was ultimately incredibly respectful, and I was so moved by that, that it actually made me braver at each step. Like, when we were first shooting, I thought that we might be making a feature. But then, you know, we kind of realized that it wasn't, and Lucy decided, like, you know, that we had enough to go with for a short. And at that point, that's when I sort of, like, took a big gulp and was like, all right, so then everyone's going to know, you know. It was kind of like coming out of the closet or something, but not as cool. like, I wish I was a lesbian, like, all the way. Everyone's a little bit of a lesbian. But it was amazing, you know, like, it was really, like, facing a wave as opposed to just letting it pummel you. It was almost like, I was like, okay, so the wave is coming, what are we going to do? And she was like, this is what happened last time with Kevin, so, you know, it was really helpful to talk to her and be with her and, like, and get through it, like, together in a way, you know. But I have to say, like, my friends and my family are amazing, and I think I have a really good support system in place, and I feel like that's why I can do it, you know, that's why I can talk about it, is because of the people who are behind me.
We should wrap up this portion, but I should say the film is going to be broadcast on HBO.
During Truth. Huntington's Disease Awareness Month next year. I wanted to get up, and I'm also two things. I wanted to thank Chicken and Egg Pictures, who are amazing.
They were so good.
And who were an amazing emergency support system and have this awesome Women on Screen initiative, which we love because we need more representation of women like Marianna, amazing women on screen and indeed behind the camera, dare I say. And the second, the Huntington's Disease Society of America is here, and stand up, please.
Louise Vetcher's here. You guys are right amazing. There. That's Louise, and we raised some money at a event that we had, and we'd quite like to raise some more money. We raised a big bunch of cash, and we really need everybody. We don't just need people who have money. Like, you could help with your efforts. You can help with your passion. You can help with your enthusiasm. It would just be great to raise awareness in general so that people know about it, you know? And I do think this is the generation. Like, this is the moment in time where we can just push it over the edge. Like, we have an opportunity to really change the world. And my dad is sick, and he's been sick for a long time, but I'm not sick, and it's almost like there's a clock ticking, you know. So I just feel like we're all in this together in a way, and I thank you guys for coming out on a Sunday. It's Sunday, right?
And we'll be outside with flyers and,
yes,
and everything. And thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you,
and thank you to the festival.
Thank you
we
very
love
much.
You guys so much.